Well, in other news now, in Russia and Turkey have vowed to strengthen their military cooperation despite pressure from the U.S. against Ankara's purchase of Russian S-400 missile system. Now, Turkish President Recep Erdogan arrived in Moscow, where he held detailed talks with the Russian President Vladimir Putin. Erdogan said that the S-400 deal is done and his country will not submit to pressure to cancel the agreement. He added that procurement of military equipment is Turkey's sovereign right. Putin described the S-400 contract as a top priority in cooperation between the two countries. He added that the two countries are also discussing other weapon deals.
Сейчас, когда основные силы террористов разгромлены, важно сосредоточиться на окончательной стабилизации обстановки на земле и продвижении процесса политического урегулирования в соответствии с резолюцией 2254 Совета безопасности Организации Объединенных Наций.
And while Turkey's purchase of the Russian missile system marked the first such contract for a NATO member, the U.S. and other NATO allies had said that the S-400 aren't compatible with the alliance's weapon system. Washington had also said that the missile system could compromise the security of its F-35 fighter jets that Turkey stands to receive. Remember, the United States has asked Turkey to junk its agreement with Russia. U.S. Vice President Mike Pence said that Turkey would risk its NATO membership and its participation in the F-35 fighter program if it chooses to go ahead with the S-400 deal.
Turkey's purchase of a $2.5 billion S-400 anti-aircraft missile system from Russia poses great danger to NATO and to the strength of this alliance. The fact that Turkey is moving ahead with these plans, even after the United States has made available the Patriot air defense system, is deeply troubling. The Pentagon made clear earlier this week, and I repeat today, if Turkey completes its purchase of the Russian S-400 missile system, Turkey risks expulsion from the joint F-35 program, which will harm not just Turkey's defense capacity, but it may cripple many of the Turkish component manufacturers that supply that program.
Now, a day after Pence's warning, Erdogan said that delivery of Russian missiles will in fact begin just this July. Now, in Moscow, Putin and Erdogan's talks were not limited just to the S-400. The leaders spoke about the completion of the pipeline that will carry Russian gas to Turkey and also about the planned construction of Turkey's first nuclear power plant. Erdogan pledged to introduce exemptions for Russian businessmen willing to invest funds in Turkey.
Последние годы турецкий бизнес открыл для себя многие российские регионы. Владимирскую, Пензенскую, Калужскую области, Краснодарский и Ставропольский края. Есть потенциал для развития сотрудничества с Республикой Крым. Свободные ниши там быстро заполняются, в том числе иностранными инвесторами.
There was also discussion on Syria. Russia and Turkey have closely coordinated moves on Syria. The two countries struck a deal in September 2018 to create a security zone in the northern province of Idlib. This is Erdogan's third visit to Russia this year. This not only underlines the increasing close cooperation between the two countries, but also hints at Turkey's willingness to defy Washington.